Hey everyone, for today's video, we'll be taking a look at an entry-level Intel B760 motherboard, the Gigabyte B760M DS3H AX-DDR4, sporting support for Intel's 13th generation Raptor Lake CPUs, all while serving up DDR4 support. Let's see if this board is any good. Now the B760M DS3H AX-DDR4 that we have here today, as its name implies, sports the new Intel B760 chipset and sits within the ultra-durable series of product offerings targeted at the entry level, placing beneath the Gaming X and Aura series of products by Gigabyte. In keeping with the brand identity of the ultra-durable series of product offerings, the board comes in a black-colored box with the ultra-durable logo splashed across the front in a bronze color. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. Let's set aside the board for now to see what accessories Gigabyte has included with it. First up, we get a Wi-Fi antenna. And this is accompanied by two SATA 3 cables. We do also get an I/O shield, as well as a quick start leaflet. With that, onto the board itself. With the board out of the packaging, we see that Gigabyte has gone for a black colored PCB with line patterns in grey for a rather busy looking appearance. The board does not come with an integrated I/O shield design and has black colored heatsinks all around. Do note that this board does not come with built-in RGB LED accents, though it does of course come with onboard RGB headers. I'll talk about the locations of these headers later on in this video. As an entry-level offering, the board doesn't come with full heatsink coverage for the VRMs. In terms of power delivery, Gigabyte has included 6+2+1 power stages for the board. The Intel B760 chipset sits beneath this passive heatsink right here, and for M.2 drive cooling, Gigabyte has included a M.2 drive heatsink for one out of the two M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. For memory support, the B760M DS3H AX-DDR4 comes with 4 DDR4 slots with support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR4 5333 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a dual tab design. Do note that this board is also available in a DDR5 variant, so you might want to do a check on the product name before confirming your purchase. In terms of front panel USB connectivity, we get a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header that provides support for up to 2 front panel USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. While still on the topic of front panel USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses 2 USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for 2 USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Some interesting features to highlight: we get an onboard reset switch that is also what Gigabyte terms a multi-key button, where it can be remapped by end users within the BIOS to serve a variety of different functions, such as to switch on and off the RGB lighting effects of supported peripherals that are connected to the board, and so on. We do also get a Q-Flash Plus button right here that allows you to update the BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card. For expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 4.0 x16 slot that sports the Easy Latch feature. Easy Latch is essentially an oversized graphics card retention tab that helps make removing a graphics card from the board less of a painful affair. Also included are two PCIe 3.0 x1 slots. In the storage department, Gigabyte has included 4 SATA 3 ports, with 2 ports in a right-angled configuration and the remaining 2 ports in a straight-angled configuration. For M.2 slots, it comes with 2 PCIe 4.0 x4 M.2 slots. Do note that these two slots support NVMe SSDs only. M.2 SATA drives are not supported. For audio, Gigabyte has included an entry-level Realtek ALC-897 audio codec, while wired internet connectivity is courtesy of Realtek's RTL8125BG chip that provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. For wireless internet connectivity, do note that the wireless chipset that comes included with the board varies according to the board revision number. This can be checked by simply looking at the sticker that is stuck to the side of the motherboard box, like so, or looking for the revision number on the board itself. Now for this particular board that I have here, revision 1.0, it comes with AMD's RZ608 Wi-Fi 6E module that serves up Bluetooth 5.2 connectivity as well. Revision 1.1, on the other hand, comes with Intel's AX210, which is also a Wi-Fi 6E part but with Bluetooth 5.3 support instead. Revision 1.2 comes with the Intel AX211 module that supports the Wi-Fi 6E standard and also has Bluetooth 5.3 support. Finally, the latest revision of this board as of producing this video, revision 1.3, comes with Realtek's RTL8852CE that serves up Wi-Fi 6E connectivity and Bluetooth 5.3 support. Just something for you folks to take note of, especially if you realize that the board that you've got has a different Wi-Fi module from the board featured in this video. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 4 fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included is a single addressable RGB header and a 12-volt standard RGB header located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, as you can see, the B760M DS3H AX DDR4 doesn't come with an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with 2 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, a PS2 mouse and keyboard combo port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors, a HDMI 2.0 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, 2 DisplayPort 1.2 connectors that support display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, 3 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A port, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. With that, the Gigabyte B760M DS3H AX DDR4 comes across as a value for money microATX Intel B760 motherboard offering, where even at the entry level, it manages to serve up features such as 2.5 gigabit Ethernet and Wi-Fi 6E at its price bracket. One point to consider though is the value proposition that low to mid-range Intel B760 boards have against motherboards powered by its predecessor chipset, the Intel B660. That is, while such B660 boards are still available to purchase new on the market. For instance, the Gigabyte B660M DS3H AX DDR4 that I reviewed some time back, which is the direct predecessor of the B760 board in this video, has pretty much the same set of features and also has support for 13th generation Raptor Lake CPUs. Now, assuming that such brand new B660 boards are cheaper than B760 boards, you might find that the money saved from getting a new B660 board instead could be put to use on the other components of your PC build. As of its launch in January 2023, the B760M DS3H AX DDR4 is available in Singapore for a price of around SGD 232, or for you international folks, around $140 from e-commerce platforms such as Newegg. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.